Hi, folks. Audiomatron here. You know, I thought it's been a while since I've done a drum video, so I figured I'd do one today. But, you know, rather than do one where I just show off and it's all polished, well, about as polished as it could be when I'm playing anyways, I figured I would do a practice video, you know, kind of show you guys how I practice, which I already recorded the video. I'm just recording this intro now to kind of go with it. But, yeah, so, you know, I want to record me messing up and me exploring and me fooling around and, you know, seeing what I can learn or do or whatever. And the idea was that I was going to have commentary on it, but iMovie on my computer keeps telling me no, keeps bombing out on me. So anyways, y'all check this out. Let me know what you think in the comments.
Alright, so here we are, starting off with something simple. Nothing too complicated, just a nice, solid is a relative term here, groove. Shaky with the fillers, but hopefully that'll tighten up as we move along here. Something you may have seen that I've been able to add to my bag of tricks in the last couple of years has been the ability to continue to click four on the, click quarter notes on the hi-hat with my left foot as I continue to play with my other limbs. That's something that really probably should have been learned early on, but I neglected for many years. And here's the exercise that I used to learn how to do that. I saw this on YouTube, I don't recall where, but it's been very helpful. Here, I break it down into its various parts to see how they fit together. Now we'll try it clicking eighth notes on the hi-hat. I like to come back and visit this one every now and then, although I have varying degrees of success. Not today, I guess. Now we'll see how the old double stroke roll's doing. Dirty as ever. Got a bit of chicken wing action going on there. we'll see what else I can do while still keeping rooted to that quarter note on the hi-hat with the left foot. I like to use a lot. I'm not really sure what you call that, but I use it quite often in my play. I like to play with these little, I guess you call them Swiss Army triplets, where I kind of alternate between the two toms there. To kind of doing this sort of, I don't know what you call it, like kind of tribal dance beat sort of thing, where I try to keep the hi-hat on the upbeat there. Problem I've always had is I don't have good aim. I hit the rims way too much. It's something I gotta work on. I guess that's just muscle memory, perhaps. I don't know. Pick up the old double bass drum there for a minute. My cats are sweating me hardcore right now. They must be hungry. That's another thing I've liked to play with lately. I don't have a name for it, but kind of alternating, sticking with the double bass drum triplets. And you keep seeing me bend down to scoot something on the ground. That's my other bass drum pedal that keeps creeping away from me. I've never been able to put this stupid thing in its place. I'm sure there's like some simple trick that I should know, but I don't know it. now, just to give the left foot a bit of a workout, I'm going to attempt just some simple beats that would normally be easy with the right foot, but doing it with my left instead. So awkward. If there was ever a thing that I did that I've ever found to be difficult, I often make sure to always visit it during my practice routine. This is one of them, kind of keeping that 16th note rolling sort of pattern going with the hi-hat and doing a bass drum pattern that has doubles in it, like single foot doubles. That used to be really difficult for me at one time, and ever since I don't know if I've mastered it, but ever since I became able to do it, I kept doing it in my practices so that I don't forget how. This is a part from one of my band's old songs. My old band's old songs. Yeah. Purely self-gratification. If I do something boring or didn't go well, I make myself feel better by doing things that I know would be impressive to other people. It's really not that impressive. But it's fun nonetheless.
Stay here.
Now I'm yelling at inanimate objects. Awesome. And now we do a little bit of black metal drumming. Making an agonizing face, that's because it's agonizing. I could never play this style of music consistently. I would have muscle cramps. And we go from black metal to jazz, another genre of music that I'm terrible at playing. Actually, before I went on the big disaster job up in New York for 3 months, I'd almost started to get a handle on jazz, and then I lost it. That's what happens when you don't practice. Main thing about jazz is that I severely need to learn how to calm down, because unless we're talking about Buddy Rich, I mean, like, the drum parts in jazz are like very calm, which is in pretty stark contrast to the kind of heavy progressive rock style that I like. Now, before somebody flames me in the comments for saying that, I know there's a lot of, like, hot jazz that's got really busy drum parts, but, you know, it's still quite a different animal than what I'm used to, for sure. Now we move on to something resembling funk. Once upon a time, I had it said of me by a guy at a party with a band that I actually filled in for one evening. This guy said, "That dude's got funk written on his forehead." I didn't have anything written on my forehead, but apparently I was pretty funky once upon a time. Then I became a Rush fan, and it was all over. But I always think of one of my favorite drummers, Brian Mantia, you know, when I think of kind of like a real solid groove, funk drumming. And here I've happened upon something interesting, so... this, right here. This double paradiddle hi-hat thing. So I'm just gonna do it over and over and over again, because it makes me feel good. If you're wondering why we haven't switched camera angles in a while, and I know you are. You are. Right? Huh? Hmm. Anyways. My, iPhone, which was doing that kind of front view, ran out of storage like 7 minutes into the recording, so this is all we have, the HD camcorder with the big hard drive. Maybe I should just get a couple of camcorders, huh? Yeah, right, that costs money. This part right here, pretty interesting. It started off kind of shaky until I really focused and started thinking about what that left foot was doing. Otherwise, the thing just sits there and flails. While I was practicing today, that might end up being another good exercise in limb independence. So now we'll slow it down and examine the parts. I'll definitely have to come back to this one. That's going to be just about it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Until next time.